it was before. Y'all could see your friends right now in the street that ain't saved, and they look older than y'all. Why you look so old and we graduated together? What happened to you? No, the question is, what happened to you? A ransom's been paid for you, and it caused my continence to be revived again. Hezekiah got 15 years added on to his life, so it looked like nothing was messed up from day one. Nothing. His flesh shall be fresher than a child's. He shall return to the days of his youth. Y'all know, as soon as you get it, you get a joy like you ain't never had before. You get an excitement like you ain't never experienced before. You start slapping people high five and nobody said nothing yet. You know, back in the day when you was young, everything was word. You know, everything was exciting to you. And you, listen, you start talking about stuff that ain't even happened yet. You didn't even realize God brought you back to get you back. Because he saw you was losing it. Verse 26, he shall pray unto God and he will be favorable unto him. Now here come favor. I done been ransomed. I done got a new look. And here come my favor. Somebody need to tell somebody, here come my favor. Here comes my favor. Oh, Lord have mercy. And he shall see his face with joy. He will render unto man his righteousness. God just start giving you stuff now. God, I don't know where it was before, but you sure enough pouring it in now. And it might not come in at full force, but there's a drip that's coming. And if the drip starts to come, soon enough the water starts to pour. Because wherever there's a drip, that means there's a back of a source of water somewhere. Don't despise your drip. Don't despise your drip. Because there's a plunge of water that's coming if you stay steadfast. Look at this. Verse 27. He said, he looketh upon men. And if any say, oh, I love this because God know how to meet us. If any say, I have sinned and perverted that which was right, and it profited me not. See, he said, I'm looking for true, honest people in this season. That's what he said. Because he said, listen, if you messed up, say you messed up. He said, because I'm going to honor that even the more. Because see, it's the ones that walk around and act like they ain't did nothing. That walk around and act like they ain't messed up nothing. You set yourself back. Open up your mouth. Yeah, that was me. I did it. I said it. I did it. And get it out the way, because there's too much at your midpoint that got to take you into your end. Sinned and perverted. And what was so key to me, he said, and if anyone say it, if any say it, good God from Zion, and perverted that which was right, and it profaned me not. He said in verse 28, he will deliver his soul from going into the pit, and his life shall see the light. So if you in here today, and you might be the one that said, you know what, I done perverted, profaned, and did everything else contrary to God, he gave you a chance today too. I love God because he covers every avenue. Verse 29 says, he said, lo, and we going back to Kings because you know we got to finish that. And I promise we're going to be going. Y'all just hold on just a second. Verse 29 says, lo, all these things worketh God oftentimes with man. This ain't no surprise to God. Surprise. You can't surprise him. You can't surprise him because he said this happens oftentimes. I've seen it before. I've been in this thing long enough. I ain't surprised when you go off. He said, oftentimes this goes down. Oh, man, that messed me up because you think that you, God, man, you ain't, oh, I'm not surprised. I don't care how you tried to dress it up and package it to make it a surprise. I'm not surprised. This is his word. He said, oftentimes he looketh upon men, verse 28. He will deliver his soul from going to the pit, and his life shall see the light. Lo, all these things worketh God oftentimes with who? Man. He ain't talking about nobody else in his creation. He said, this happens often with my people. But verse 30, to bring back his soul from the pit, to be enlightened with the light of the living. He said, I saw you dead. I saw you in that dark place. But I rescued you because I knew oftentimes you might lose it. But I rescued you and put you back in the light of men. Good God. Some people never even got the chance to see your dark side. Because he picked you up and put you in the light of men. But he ain't stopped there. He said in verse number 31, mark it well, O Job. Hearken unto me, Job. Hold thy peace and I will speak. You saw the illustration of me and my husband when the ransom was paid and I wrapped myself in him. He said, shut your mouth. Shut it up. Don't say another thing contrary to the things that's coming up against you. Shut your mouth because I'm going to speak. Let me speak now for the situation. You done said enough. Let me speak. Sometimes, you know, we talk too much and we talk ourselves out of our blessing. Because you never know what direction God want to go in to bless you. And you open up your mouth too quick and you might just mess up what God was already putting in position. My mother used to always tell me, only speak when spoken to. Stay yourself out of grown folk business. Get out of God's business. He said, mark it well, O Job. Hearken unto me. Hearken unto me. Hearken unto me. Hold your peace and I will speak. Here we go. If you have anything to say. Because he knew we all know how to shut up, Deacon Roger. He know we always got to say something. He know we always got to come out the side of our mouth. He know we got to ask.